Hi everyone, my name is Ovidius and I'm a sysadmin here at Oxylabs. I will introduce you to SOCKS5 proxies, explain their benefits and use, and answer if they can be detected. There are two main protocols on which proxies operate, HTTP and SOCKS. While HTTP proxies are meant for proxying HTTP web requests only, SOCKS5, the latest version of the SOCKS protocol, aims to be a broader proxy for arbitrary forms of traffic. We've covered the differences between HTTP and SOCKS protocols in our blog post. Follow the link if you're interested. Considering the benefits of SOCKS5 proxies, we can list three of them. First, basically anything can be fitted to work with it. SOCKS5 supports arbitrary forms of traffic, which makes it possible for software that doesn't directly want to cooperate with proxying to still be able to be encapsulated in a SOCKS5 tunnel. Secondly, SOCKS5 proxies are highly popular since any programming language or system has tools for this type of proxy. Finally, it works well with high volume tasks. SOCKS5 is often used for tasks such as email traffic using SMTP or even UDP-based video streaming. As we said, SOCKS5 might be useful even for software that is somewhat difficult to use with proxies. For example, some applications may not want you to use proxies due to performance or abuse prevention reasons, even though you are using proxies for positive purposes. You can use so-called SOCKSifiers, proxy wrappers that can force traffic made by the application to go through your chosen SOCKS proxy, very often without the application even being made aware of this. In general, if whatever traffic you're interested in being proxied is based on either TCP or UDP, there's a way to make it work via SOCKS. Of course, many applications also directly support SOCKS5. Even if an app doesn't have an entry for proxy configuration in its settings, some simply use the operating system's default proxy configuration. As with HTTP proxies, if you're writing custom software that you want to use proxies with, most programming languages or software frameworks have libraries that allow usage of proxies, including SOCKS5. Using proxies naturally raises questions on their detection rate, and this isn't different for SOCKS5. Can it be detected? Well, it's not a yes or no question, as it depends on the program settings, tools, and use cases. If you use SOCKS5 for web scraping, it won't differ from most types of other simple proxies. So your detection rate, number of proxy IPs, how you form your requests, and so on are still important. In the end, you should still be mindful of all the other factors that contribute towards scraping detection other than just the proxy protocol you use. I hope this video has given you an idea of what SOCKS5 proxies are and how you can make the best out of it. Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions about proxies or would like to find out more about any other specific topic, contact us at hello@oxylabs.io or simply write a comment below. And also, if you like this content, smash that like button and please share it on your social media. See you in other videos.